Economy cars have been on cruise control for quite some time now. Traditionally, this hasn't been the segment for frills or fun, and 9 times out of 10 performance has taken a back seat to practicality. Until recently, this was the case with American cars and is one of the major reasons manufacturers like Toyota and Honda managed to garner such a large foothold of the market with cars like the Civic and Corolla in the 1980s and 1990s. But the times they are a-changin', and manufacturers that have historically struggled in this space, namely Chevrolet and Ford, want a piece of the practical car pie. Enter the fun-loving 2012 Ford Fiesta, now in its sophomore year. And after a 31-year absence, Ford's Fiesta made its return to North American shores in 2011. Truthfully, it couldn't have come a better time. With gas prices continuously in flux and American buyers looking to jump into more fuel-efficient and economical cars, the compact and subcompact segment has really started to flourish, and not just with cheaper choices that will appeal to your wallet, but ones people actually wanted to drive. Does the 2012 Fiesta manage to deliver a vehicle that neatly manages to be both fun and frugal? It sure looks that way. Let's get this out of the way right now. The 2012 Ford Fiesta is one hot little hatch. There, we said it. Not only does it exhibit more than a hint of European styling appeal, but it's not restricted to the old world any longer. With Ford finally bringing the popular car to North American shores. Indeed, one of the great things about modern subcompact cars is their ability to be just as easy on your eyes as they are on your wallet. And the Fiesta is no different. At its face, the Fiesta sports a confident front fascia along with sharpened headlamps and sculpted wheel arches. Ford's signature gaping maw found on many of its newer models makes an appearance too, albeit in smaller form. At the side, the Fiesta looks sleek, almost elegant. The arching roofline tapers out towards the rear where it is met by the Fiesta's climbing tail lights and dipping hatch. Of course, if words were flowers, manufacturers' tendency to describe their cars with such language could plant a garden in your ears. Most of the time it's overblown PR hype. Quote,